I graduated in 1982, and at that time there was a freeze on hiring teachers back then. So I wasn't able to get a job right away, so I had to sub at different schools in South Tampa mostly. Let me back up a little bit. My mom was working in the office here. So she had been here almost 10 years, no, probably 12 years, 13 years by that time. So I didn't want to come to Mitchell because this was her school. I grew up kind of here because she worked here. Even though I didn't come to school here, I came to all their like fall festivals and different things like that. So I was familiar with Mitchell, but I didn't want to come here because this was her school. But then one day the secretary called me and said that we need a substitute, and I couldn't refuse. So I came and I subbed here, and it had a great day. And then the next thing I know, the principal called me in and said, I have an opening, a teacher's leaving for maternity reasons. And so I came and subbed for 3 months, and it was great. And it was in kindergarten, because when I graduated, I wanted to be a fourth or fifth grade teacher. I didn't want to do primary grades. And so when he said kindergarten, at first I thought, oh, there's no way. But then I went in there and I had the three best months ever. And when I was done, he recommended that I go back and get my early childhood degree, which I did. And then that fall, he called me up. It was like a week before school started, saying that he had an opening in first grade. And I came, and the rest is history. I stayed at Mitchell. I didn't want to go anywhere. I was at a perfect school. My mom and I worked 1 year together. She was in the office and I was downstairs. That's where I got my early bird kind of thing, because she had to be here early to open up the office. So I would come early with her. We came in one car, and I would come early, get my room set up, and I just got in the habit of doing that. So even after she retired, I kept on working here and coming early. I taught first grade with the four most wonderful people. I always say I hit the jackpot when I came here, because they were a family already, and they welcomed me into their group. And we were the envy back then of the whole school. Everybody wanted to be part of first grade. I had a wonderful team leader named Lorene Allen, and she taught me all the things that you don't learn in school about running your classroom day to day. And I remember her telling, you know, just love the kids, and they'll do anything that you want them to do. And that's kind of what I've held on to all these years, that if you show them love and that you care for them, they'll do anything for you. And I taught first grade for 6 years. I loved it. But then it was time for me to try doing. I was so dependent on my team that maybe it was time for me to grow. So I took over. I went to second grade and I taught there for 4 years. And then in the middle of the year, Dr. Haynes, Joyce Haynes was the principal at the time. She said, I think, you know, I would like you to be the gifted teacher for primary. They were starting the primary gifted classes. And the rest is history. I ended up being there 28 years in the gifted program. And I love every minute of it. It's funny, I always tell everybody that things don't always work out the way you plan, because I wanted to be an intermediate teacher. And look, 38 years later, I never taught higher than third grade. I've been in first, second, or third for all these years. And I loved every minute of it. And I didn't want to come to Mitchell. I ended up being at Mitchell for 38 years. So it's it's neat the way things work out. I think the closeness in this, of the staff has kept me here at Mitchell all these years. It's like a family. This has been my second home. I don't have like my own children, so these are my children. And I've had families that I've taught 3 and 4 of their kids. And I just feel that this is my home. And it's been hard these last couple of weeks. I'm excited about retiring, but also it's hard to leave. I'm not a person of change. As you could tell, I've been here so long. But this is my home, and so I've had days that I'm real happy, and then days that I'm a little sad. The kids will say something to me, it makes me think about something. Some of my favorite memories, I think most of them involve the kids, and I wish. Now that I wrote down some of the things that they have said to me and told me, and I think I would have a bestseller book if I could remember some of the things that they told me and the stories and things that have happened here at Mitchell through the years. But I think one thing stands out to me is that I've been here through some high points in my life. I got back in 2000, I won the Milken Award, which is a National Teacher Award that they surprised me at the school with. So I think that's one memory I will never forget, because I was standing in the back of the old cafeteria that they had, and this man is speaking and he's telling about this award. And I thought it was to the school, and all of a sudden they called my name and all these cameras turned around and faced me in the back of the room. My legs were like rubber. I couldn't even walk up to the front, and it was just unbelievable. And then they send you to the Florida Award ceremony, which was in Orlando. And then in the following June, they send me to California, where you pick up the award and everything at the national convention. So that would have to be a highlight. But then I got to present at the Blue Ribbon Conference a couple of times, once in Denver and once in Spartanburg. It's in North Carolina, South Carolina. I can always get them mixed up. But it was so neat with fellow teachers I did that with. But it's the day-to-day things that I remember the most. You know, being with the kids, things, talking with the teachers, being with people that I cared about and loved. Also, they got me through some rough times. I mean, when I lost my mom, you know, that was a big thing. And the school was so supportive, and they got me I came back to school right after it, and they kind of got me through the rest of the year with the love and not only the teachers, but the parents here at Mitchell, the kids. And then this year I wasn't here at the beginning of the year. I was in a bad car accident like the Friday before school teachers came back. And I was out for 2 months with a recovering from a broken leg and kneecap and things, and the parents ended up bringing me meals to my house, and teachers calling me and texting me if I needed anything, and friends from school taking me to therapy because I couldn't drive. And so, like I said, they've been through some good times and not so good times. So I would tell future teachers to stick with it. I'm going to be honest, you're going to have days that you think, I remember my first year saying, I made a big mistake by becoming a teacher, because it was a hard day. But then the next day was wonderful. So to stick with it, get make connections with the people at your school. You'll find someone that you feel comfortable with to work with, that will have your back, will help you through things. And like I say, stick with it, because you might be having this awful day, and then one little thing that one of the kids will say to you, or do for you, or something will happen that will change your whole outlook on your profession. I there's some days I go home, I'm thinking, oh, I'm tired, this is it, you know. And then other days I think, wow, what a great day. And all the love that you get from the students, it's unconditional, you know. Especially that I teach the younger ones, they're very blunt. They'll tell you things, you know, they'll tell you things maybe you don't want to hear, but they also are very sweet and they're very loving. And so stick with it. It's worth it. It really is. I think just having the free time to do some things that I've been wanting to do, maybe go places that I have always wanted to go, getting to do things that, you know, relaxing, staying home, not being a rush to do things. And I'm gonna work part-time at a local preschool, so like part-time, but just to go and have fun and work with the kids, not to do all the, I want to be more like the helper, you know. And that's, so I'm gonna do that and just be with family and friends and get to do some maybe traveling and things like that.